Hey, hello to the people on live stream. We're just getting going here. The live stream feed is very erratic today, so bear with us. If we do have a failed live stream, we'll keep trying to reconnect. Let's see what's going on there. Looks like they're just about ready to go, so I'll put the music back on for now and be another couple of minutes maybe.
Just a moment there, you can show you like this, should paint all the...
So, if I do this, it should appear on the other side.
I think we're still just getting set up there with Mr. Keshe, Rick.
Okay, yep.
Mr. Keshe, are you ready to go then?
We are ready to go.
Okay, so just give me one moment. I'm going to stop the YouTube and just restart it.
Has the problem with live stream sorted?
Rick?
Somewhat. I'm broadcasting now in a lesser quality and it's holding, but it took a long time to connect. There's something wrong with the... cable networks. I see that Vancouver and Southern Alberta are down for their networks right now. So there's problems.
So happening. We got trapped in the Canadian problem.
Yes. Okay. Yes. All right. I'd say
it's
so.
Good. Edit file. Ooh, menu. Edit. Oh, I don't need to go up there. It's all here. Edit. Ooh. It's good. Ready to go when you are.
Phase back on the music and
Tim's just stopped the YouTube here, so
okay, you need another minute or so to get that going in, right?
Just a moment, yeah, not too long.
Just let me know.
I need to move. I can't see right now.
Yes, good morning.
And some viewers.
He's the younger viewer. Is he going to the nursery today or is he home?
He is going to school today. And I see Carolee's here today here as well, so he's got his video running.
Pardon?
Oh, yes. So, Mr. Keshe, if you want to look at your screen.
Hello.
Mr. Keshe, if you want to look at your screen, there's Carolee's video.
Yeah, yeah.
You can introduce Carolee at some point.
Okay.
Okay, Carolee, let Rick start the session before you go.
Okay. So we'll bring you in, Carl, okay?
Okay.
Yes, we can see it, no problem.
Okay, so Rick, one more moment here and I'll go. Okay. And then please start your recordings. Everybody start your recordings. Rick, you'll be recording.
Fabio is in his nest. Start recording. Okay, good morning.
Okay, we're recording.
Rick, we are ready when you are.
Still waiting on Vince here, I believe.
Go ahead, Rick.
Oh, you're ready? Okay, thanks, Vince.
Yeah.
Okay, welcome everyone to the afternoon session, Thursday, October 29th, 2015. And once again, we are working with the Blueprint Teaching Week and learning more about the Power Magrav Blueprint and some of the probably more in the theoretical end this afternoon. I'm not sure what Mr. Keshe has in mind, but he's ready to go, so let's let him take over. Go ahead, Mr. Keshe.
Yes, good afternoon. Good day to you, as usual, whenever you listen to these teachings. We are in the second part of today, Thursdays, as part of the Blueprint Week. As I said, because of what we added as the capacitors today, we'll carry on with the Blueprint Week on next Tuesday and Wednesday. On Monday we are not here. And then we'll see how people, the systems they made, will show us what capabilities they have. We've just been, during the lunch, speaking to people who are testing the systems in the background for the what do you call it, for different governments. And something interesting has come up, is that the old type of the light bulbs, if you know which one I'm talking, not the saving light bulbs, the ones which are like this, with gas in them, they seem to be blowing up after a while with the system when it starts nano-coating itself. So it means the energy of the plasma builds into the system as it wants to nano-coat itself, it cannot absorb. So the system literally expands itself and destroys itself. So these light bulbs has to be considered in Western Europe. These are outlawed, so we don't consider them. But maybe in the nations where you have these kind of light bulbs, you better take note when or as you add the system into your system. I think Rick wins in the Magrav at Keshe Foundation, or Keshe Foundation /Magrav, we have to add this about the light bulbs as a notice that there is such a possibility, that people are aware of it. We asked, I've been told I have to use this, it looks better. So I'm using it to satisfy some people who work around here that would like it to have it this way. If you can't see it, it's no problem, but it's like a chalk, but it's good. We have Carly in China, who's going to show us his systems. Carl, are you there? Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Hello.
Hi, Carl.
Hello, Ms. Keshe. And this is my system, Carl system. You can see it. Okay.
Look.
Okay.
Four.
How do you choose
four?
Hello, I'm here. Hello?
Yes, I can hear you. Why have you chose four stackers?
Because I want to increase the power.
So okay.
I use three at first, then I try four of them and to see how much it can increase.
Yeah.
And this is my original capacitor.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And this is the BC turn, and I also use this B as a permitted capacitor for the original spin system.
Can see? Yes, but these are in series. You are using, we have never tested these capacitors the way you are doing. These are capacitors. These are you are going on the series, not on parallel.
And we also found that with this in serial setup, we can charge our battery in 5 minutes, 5 seconds.
Yes, you see, this is not you are working a different way. This is a beads. Am I correct?
Yeah.
We are not talking about beads. We are talking about capacitors.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this is a capacitor we made
before.
But
you have to take
it's slightly different from yours.
Beads.
And you can see the GANS coated reactor star formation. GANS coated.
I can't understand.
I use GANS to coat this reactor. You can see the red and the white color on the surface. You can see? Can you see?
Yes. Yeah.
So I totally coat the inside reactor and the outer shell with GANS.
Yeah.
So maybe I can, tomorrow I can run this system and connect them together and try to deliver the energy from this to this.
That's so fantastic. But now I understand why you've taken four rings.
Yes. So I want to ask for your advice.
I understand.
How to transfer the energy into each reactor of the star formation?
Okay. His GANS. The this is one of the fat boys, isn't it?
Yep. And I have another one in our lab. And this is our GANS. I made different GANS, and I mix them together. This is a mixture of GANS.
Yeah.
Yes. So
it's
liquidish. I'm gonna try with some heat or put it under the sun and then try it tomorrow. Maybe okay. I can finish all the work with the coil system tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to show this tomorrow and see it whether it can work or not.
Okay, so you're gonna power the fat boy with the energy of the plasma from the stacking unit.
Yeah. And I made this. This is a glasses. And the inside is a glasses spring.
What?
Glass spring.
Glass ring.
Glass spring. Glass spring inside, and I fill with GANS. And this this is entry and this is exit. And I connect the entry and the exit with a pong. So the GANs can run continuously from the entry and out from the to the exit. So this can make a very cosmetic environment for the human.
What is the lighting?
Yes. So I try this to test whether it can do any benefit to the human body.
Marco, this is like the light you were trying to create system. Just put a pipe, a coil pipe of a GANs inside another GANs where you had a fish pump.
And you can see
I've been waiting for this hat.
Yes. We try to make just like a pyramid on the top and also with a pump to pump the water, pump the GANs inside to be dynamic and release the CO2 plasmatic energy directly into the head, the emotion power of the man, of the people.
And what does it do? Does it make you any cleverer?
So we're gonna try this and to see whether it will or not.
What do you want to use it for? What are you supposed to see? That's what I want to know.
So we want to try to in different kind of diseases to see whether it will or not. So we're gonna make a lot of them to test. Then this is a pump here. You can see.
Yeah, but what are you using it for to put it on your head? This is what I don't understand.
Put on the head. With a pump to make dynamic CO2 GANs inside, so it can release the
Why are you putting it on your head? This is why what I don't understand. What are you trying to get?
I try to release the field directly into the emotion part of the body, the head.
Yeah, but what do you expect from it?
It's a professor.
You expect to be happy. You expect to cry. What is supposed to give you?
Because a professor from the university suggests us to make this shade for centralize the energy in this point, and we made this pyramid helmet.
Now I understand.
Okay.
Yeah. I saw this one in your pictures last week, but I didn't know what you're going to do with you sitting under it.
Okay. So we want to get some advice from you how to transfer this energy into the reactor star formation. Do you have any idea?
I hope I have. What are you going to do? You take the energy from the coil,
okay,
and it has to be a nano wire into your each reactor. You got to use a nano coated wire.
Yes,
and
I have nano coated wire here. So
yeah, do the normal connection between the stackers from gravitational to magnetical. Magnetical to gravitational till you go to the top, then connect it to the four motors and let it run for a few days.
Okay.
That the winding and everything inside gets nano coated with a plasma or get GANs line, and then you see you should have a control section where you can stop or add energy to each motor.
Okay, so a control system.
Yeah, each motor of your fat boy
needs
to be connected with nano wires and a way of control. You gotta leave it for a few days until everything is nano coated.
Okay.
You run your motors for a few days and see listen to the noise of the motor. If you have a speedometers, check the speed of the motor and see if your flux around the system changes. If you put it on a scale you had, the weighing scale, see if it changes and how much it changes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. I'm gone on time.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Carl.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Do we have Richard online? Has he gone very far with his system? Richard? Hello, Vancouver.
Yeah, we're here. Richard, are you there?
Yes, I am.
How far have you gone with your system, Richard?
Well, I made the bigger coils now, actually.
What?
I made bigger coils. I had first 1 millimeter coils. Now I have 1.7 millimeter coils. Now I've got them nano-coated.
Yeah.
Are you still there?
Yes, we are listening.
Okay, good. I can show you some stuff. Let me see. There you go. I'm having some disturbance.
How are you getting disturbances?
It looks like Magrav disturbance to me.
Are you running?
Not now. Let me see.
He's never happened this one. Garage scientist.
Okay.
Richard.
Okay. Richard. Yeah.
Armin says it's from you.
It's me. Okay. Yeah. Oh,
you're creating too much flux.
Well, let me see. You wanted to see some nano-coated stuff, so I have to get some gloves.
Perfectly nano-coated.
And actually treated this one with GANS already.
Pardon?
I treated this one already GANS.
You can't see anything on it.
No, it's really dark.
You have to make sure the GANS goes inside the tubes as well, fully.
Like fill it up?
Yeah, fill it up and empty it.
Yeah, okay. What I did now, I have this liquidish state of GANS. It's a bit too fluid yet.
Fabio, okay. Oh, this is a very nice lentil Dutch soup.
Yeah. So this is a GANS I made with
What did you use, Richard? What did you use
inside? I can show you.
Did you use that rare earth minerals too?
No, not yet. I got some rare earth minerals, so I'm going to try to. So basically what I did now, I took Ormus. Basically this one. And I took...
See, we lost connection here on our side. Is...
You there?
We are here, but we can't see anything. It says it's trying to connect to Zoom on a computer on the table. We gotta wait and see what it's doing.
It's GANS.
Yeah, it's GANS. It's the first generation of GANS people.
I'm trying to speak, but he's very interested. So
Yeah.
Don't mind him.
Yep. At least now that he speaks. Okay, you can show it to us now, Richard.
Okay, good. So I had this accidental GANs I made in my bucket, and this oxidizes. It's a little bit brownish, and it oxidizes really, really dark brown, almost black. And I mix this with Ormus, with a sea GANs, and this is the pure Ormus, and this is then
GANs. What is
Ormus? Ormus is the same thing, but people know it being a term as Ormus.
No, it does not behave. We got something investigated. Ormus is another material that for years they tried to push it through. Now that we understand the behavior of GANs, they're trying to attach it to us. Nothing to do with it.
We wipe away Ormus. So you've got a GANs material from C. And yes. I mixed 1 milliliter of this GANs on 60 milliliters of sea GANs. And I ended up with this material. So I figured, well, this is carrying now the energy of this GANs combined with this one. And it reacts still the same way. So you can really see the...
It's greenish.
You see? Black.
Yeah.
This is without the oxidation, you see that.
Yeah.
It's the same thing here. So it's really, and then I mixed it now, and then I took as much water out as I could. And then I put a light under it, and now it's drying since yesterday evening. So I have to wait.
So you still want to GANs coat it before you use it?
Well, I did already a dip of the coils inside the GANs to get the first coating on there. They're still a bit wet, so I can't see any discoloration in structure. When it dries, it starts crystallizing, so I have to see how the color changes.
Yeah.
But because it's a GANs that reacts to become dark, so it might be that you can't really see it on the coils while it's still there.
I see. Okay, no problem. So you think you'll be ready by Monday, Tuesday, once you make your capacitors and everything else?
Well, the capacitors are not the issue. The GANs is the issue now. I need proper amounts, so it's just drying now. I just have to finish off doing that. So that's as far as I am now with the coils. And I'm actually into the process of getting them together and connecting them. But I was trying to get a practice round here with a little set here I made to figure out how to make the connections proper and then do it on the nano-coated ones. So okay. That's how far I am now.
Thank you very much. So hopefully by Tuesday we'll see something.
I guess so. Yes. Hopefully this weekend, actually.
Okay, I'm going to stay awake whole weekend.
Well, I'm already awake for 2 minutes.
Don't make sure it's Halloween night on Saturday. Don't connect it to the wrong place.
You never know what's going to happen.
No.
Good.
Okay. Thanks very much, Richard.
You're welcome.
Thank you indeed. Is there anybody else we can go to? Is that Alex or is it David Kavanagh? Kevin Davenant.
Well, this is me, but I'm not sure whether Alex is anywhere here around.
Well, Alex has no internet access in Nigeria, so easy. Is there anything you want to show us, Kevin?
No, I'm sorry. I didn't have no time. I just have some GANs paste and some little bit of GANs, but that's it. And I experimented a little bit with deuterium oxide just for the fun of it. I don't have anything to show right now.
Oxide, they can buy it. Use for different things. Okay, is there anybody else online who wants to show anything?
It's Chandor.
Pardon?
It's Chandor here.
Hi, Sandor. You're here with your peeler?
Yeah. So I just start assembling the coils. So this is the small ring. I made all the coils, and another thing which I did, because this copper wire is very hard, so I used such a gas torch to heat up the wire and to soften it to make it easier to twist it later. I do this before the nano coating. Just what I'm concerned, the length of these wires, I left them pretty long, so maybe I have to adjust them before the nano coating to have the proper length for them. So this is the smaller coil. This will be a longer set.
Oh my God, it's full of snakes in that house.
Putting them together.
Is that, that must be a huge coil, this one. Yeah. How big, how many turns? Couple of thousand turns?
No, 160 turns. Maybe the spacing is a bit looser than others have. Ah. I consider to have here about 1 millimeter between them to make the nano coating better, because if they keep the liquid in the second process, they don't coat uniformly. So I try to avoid capillary effect there. And this will be here. And probably I have too much.
Okay.
So it's about, how to say, it's
12, 17 centimeters
in diameter.
Okay.
So the circle will be about 17 centimeters. It's not a huge one. And this will come in the center. I think it's just normal size.
It looks like the center of the Earth. Two coils and the gap in between.
Yes.
That's perfect. Thank you very much. So we see you energizing the house by the end of next week.
If I can finish with producing guns and all, so I don't want to quick it, to do it in a quick way. I don't want to do it properly. So I have not much guns, so I have to produce some more. So this is a combined guns. It's a CHP, but I put.
You know what I hear from you lot? We better open a guns bank. People can, you know, donate blood. You can donate guns.
Yes,
good shortage of it.
Had that idea a long time ago.
Pocketer, where the hell is it? We are producing at the moment about, I think, a few kilos a day of cans in the factory. We have to meet 100,000 unit per week demand.
Well, and another thing, if I find where I put them. I found, I'm seeking to find some more exotic metals of higher order in the periodic table. I found such a hard disks which I extracted from the hard disk drives, and it said that it is covered either with molybdenum, either with platinum. So maybe that will give a different kind of guns if combining with the nano-coated copper. Maybe I have to adjust the salinity as well accordingly to use different salts, not just the.
Use a current, use a low current to produce large amount quickly if you want, and then leave it outside to oxidize.
We'll try that too.
That'll do. Thank you very much, Sandra.
Thank you.
Anything else? We'll see most probably on Tuesday. Oh, look, this is when he was young. Very impressive. Sandor, I sent you an email from a Hungarian group. Have you received it?
I think, just a second. That from the...
Yesterday.
Just a second, received hundreds of emails.
Yeah, it's from somebody down there. Have a look at it, read it.
Just a second.
we'll talk about it later on. Yes, just check.
Later.
Okay. Thank you very much. Anything in the background? Anybody else?
I see Max Bejere. How do you say your last name, Max? I think he has something to show here. Let me, whoops. There we go. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, can you hear me? Okay. hello, my name is, second name is Bekere, very easy. It's a French name with accent aigu at the end. That's why it's an open E at the end. So it should be easy for you Canadians to.
Yeah, I was thinking, I thought it might have been German actually. So there you go. Okay, oh. Good. Bekere.
Bekere.
Bigre.
Guy's good at it here. Guy's French beside me.
What do you have to show us today?
Well, as you I showed you yesterday, I finished the coil. And I did my first nano coating starting about in the evening, 8 or 9 o'clock. And it's I can show you after about, what is it, 18 hours, how it looks. Yeah, can you see that?
Yeah, good enough.
Maybe I have to, it's still wet a little bit. So that's how it looks after about 18 hours.
Now you gotta put it in the GANS material.
Well, I think it should still dry some longer, don't you think? It's 18 hours, probably. I had to give it a second shot and then dry it out, I think.
Yeah, you got to wash it and dry it.
Yeah, the problem I have that with the GANS is similar as actually the, you know, the one before Sandor did have. How to make the right GANS very quick, so I'm able to produce this product.
The way we do it is you connect the system to 1.5 volt and half amp to the plates, and you will see that the GANS just flows into the water. And then what you're going to do, you just drain some of the water and leave it. And it gets oxidized greenish on top and it's still brown on the bottom.
What and kind of plates you're using for this mixture?
1.5 amp. Sorry, 1.5 volt and half amp. You can go to 2 and it goes to 1 amp, something like this. And you get the whole bucket literally full. Your plate disappears in a matter of half a day.
So with the GANS, you have a mixture of GANS, different GANS, don't you?
Yeah, if you got a zinc, you can do it with a zinc plate and the copper. And if you have aluminium, do it with aluminium and let it to oxidize. You got to allow it to oxidize.
Okay, I have zinc here. I have copper here. I tried it with actually nano-coated copper, 2 nano-coated copper plate with your OmegaMon setup, but it really didn't produce in the last.
No, one of the plates has to be nano-coated, not both.
Ah, I thought both can be nano-coated.
No, one of the plates has to be. You have to create a gradient of the plasma.
Okay, I have such of that one, but probably not enough for the paste. I'll try to make that as soon as possible.
You can use, if you can do the same thing with a piece of copper wire. Connect a piece of copper wire into the liquid and it just disappears. It just become GANS into the bottom.
Actually, I think I throw that away. I had the, you know, this from the battery, from the phone battery, it took out that copper, thin copper
that
plate.
Copper battery is the best one.
And it really vaporized in the box, and I have just little pieces to collect now. So I can put this again in there.
Yeah, you can use this battery, what I call, I've got one here. If you can see it, It's one of them here. I use them. I used to buy batteries in hundreds. The guys thought this guy must be crazy what he's doing, buying so many second-hand destroyed batteries. But they didn't know it's the best way to produce nanomaterial and nanosheets. And you just connect it to electric power points and you get what you want from it. And it nanocoats very well and it produces nanomaterial very well and the GANs.
Okay, so that's my next really step.
Go to the telephone shop, says, do you have any batteries you want to sell? They usually sell it for about 50 cents because they want to get rid of it. It's one of the best way to get batteries.
Okay.
Free copper. Don't forget these copper sheets in the telephone batteries are of highest purity. They're of the highest purity. It's one of the best coppers you can use for GANs production.
Okay.
You spend a huge amount of money to make high purity that the batteries don't get damaged with any impurities. So if you can go to telephone companies or what you call it, telephone shops, do you have any batteries? I buy them.
Okay.
I used to pay 50 cents to 1 euro. I used to buy 100, 200. They used to collect at the time.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Anything, anybody else? How come Kevin Devon keeps on coming up?
Well, I'm not sure. We have someone called Bass Blom here. Is that the name? Okay.
You hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Yes. I made a small coil for a pen. And last night I took it out of the container and I put it in a small plastic tube. And then this morning I see a lot of like crystals growing on it. Is that good or not?
I don't know what it is, how you've done it. Pardon?
It was...
Yes, that's what I think. Did you wash your copper? Did you wash your coil?
Before or after the caustic?
After the caustic.
No.
Okay. This is crystallization of the salt from your caustic.
Yes, that's what I figured.
Yeah, so you have to wash it and then you use it. You see this a lot. I had a full bucket of it here yesterday. I went and I washed it.
Okay.
That's all it is. Just give it a quick rinse and it goes away.
Okay, that's fine then.
You see it here, if we can come close, this box had some. Wash the box and it still comes back. As long as you have some caustic, you get it on it. Yes, there was a tray full. I just.
It'd be best to use distilled water in that case, or is it that critical?
Pardon?
It'd be best to use distilled water to rinse the coils and so on.
Yes.
Okay.
I usually use distilled water. We use distilled water here to wash the systems because with the normal water, depending on where you come, some calciums and the rest of it. Anything else?
You have to share the image itself, Bass.
Pardon?
Okay, I think Bass wants to show an image here. So, yeah, it's best to open the image. Best to open the image first, Bass, and then select it as in the screen share. Maybe you want to stop the screen share, then open the picture. And then you can start the screen share again.
Okay. As I see it on my screen.
Make sure we can't see any files on the screen, please.
Yeah, it's not good to show your desktop and so on.
Okay, well, never mind. It was the crystals and we know what it is.
Okay.
I have another question too. The two coils. inside each other, and then they go into the nano coating.
Yes.
Isn't that a problem for the smaller coil inside the bigger one?
You can do them separately and then put them in. You see the way I showed you, I don't like to take risks.
Uh-huh.
No use taking chances. Yeah. If you look at the, I try to show it, can we go on my camera? If you can see it. The nano coating was done separate. And then the GANS coating is done separately, and then you put the coils in. This way, there is no chances of something might not happen.
Okay.
So depends how good you are in, and how confident you are. I'm not very confident, so I don't take chances.
Yeah, because what I also noticed on my little coil, the one that has the crystals, that some parts were still plain copper after 24 hours in the caustic steam. And then I think, well, maybe that's where I touched the bare copper wire with my fingers.
Not really, because you work on such a high temperature when you create caustic, all the fat gets washed off. One of the reasons they use caustic for cleaning pipes is the heat, boiling water, which is creating to distill. Do in a way high temperature does it. So if you have, I used to think the same, and then one day I came to understand if you put any fat in such a high temperature, there is no way that it can exist.
Okay, and I also did it in a glass bottle. Some say it has to be in a plastic thing.
No, you can do it in anything. You can do it in a steel bucket.
Okay.
It's the temperature which creates it. But with a glass jar, you lose the temperature very fast. That's the problem.
Yep. Did I just hear you say that when making guns, my copper plate will disappear?
Why?
I thought I just heard you say that.
No. Depends. If you want to produce guns and you use a high current to produce guns very rapidly, you connect your wires negative to the nano coated plate or the plate you want to do it. The conversion from atomic to nano to GANS is so rapid that in a day or two, most of your atomic structure converts into a GANS.
Yep. Okay, so the negative has to go to the nano coated, because I see a lot of people asking that question.
Yeah. Correct, Alan? Yes.
The master. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Any other question? Everybody's asleep, everybody's dozing after lunch. It happens to me. Anything else, Vince?
I was talking to myself with the microphone.
It was a nice conversation, I hope.
Yeah, I agreed with myself and everything. We have Salama. Salama, I just made into a panelist here. Can you speak, Salama? Okay, I see your microphone's open.
Sorry, somebody made me a panelist, so I don't have anything to say.
Oh, you had your hand up, so I thought you had something to show.
It could be a mistake, I'm sorry.
Okay, maybe next time.
Yeah, thank
you. Okay, anybody? I've got a couple of other viewers with their hand up. Let's see what we have. Mark and Shankara. Mark Merb, can you
hear me? I'm doing well.
Hi. Can you say who you are and what you'd like to show?
I'm very far away. And I'm pointing my camera there, but it's not showing you. Do I have screen share?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You see?
I gotta move the camera to the other side.
Okay, we'll just get that lined up there.
You can see your glasses.
Okay, well, I can just point the camera around to this. Can you see that?
You see a lot of coil on top of each other.
Okay, yeah, now we can see it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's where I am.
That's nice. By Monday, Tuesday, you'll be ready?
Probably it's going to take longer.
Ah, okay. Don't forget to make your capacitors.
Well, I will. I won't forget.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Vince, Rick, do you see Benjamin anywhere on the line?
Benjamin, not Bartholomew Ben Israel, but it's a different Benjamin, I think you mean.
No, I suppose
we'd have to ask him to raise his hand because there's 200 people in the panelists.
Ah, okay. Benjamin from Keshe Foundation Ghana, if he's online, if they have the power supply.
I do see Bernard in that list. Would Bernard like to show what he has?
And we also have Shankara. Did you want to say something? You had your hand up, so I promoted you to a panelist. Do you have something to show?
Yeah, I had a question, and I've got a coil in my hand. I can show it to you. I don't really know how, but I can, if you like to try.
Do you know how to start your video? Okay, there we go. Just a minute.
Yeah, I just pushed on it. Looks good. Hi there.
Okay, yeah, we can see you now.
Just trying to communicate.
Great.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm thirsty.
Okay, so this is the third time I tried doing this. The first time.
Can you just wait 1 second, please? We have to open our camera. No problem. Yes?
So basically, my nano coating is half black, but then there's this blue oxidization on here. I don't know if that's very good or not.
Is that blue?
Blue.
Okay.
Yeah, it is blue.
Let's hold on. Hold on. I was hoping somebody will bring this up. Is the inside blue too as well?
Yep.
Okay. Yep. Can you have a look at your black side as well? Can you move your hand to the blue side? Let's have a look. Is it blue inside too as well or not? Mm. Or is it black inside?
I don't know. You see in there? It's blue in
it's
there.
It's blue. It's blue. Yeah. Okay, let me explain. We were discussing about this yesterday. Is this your outer ring or inner ring? This is outer ring.
Outer ring.
What we have, you caustic coated this or did you heat coated it?
Caustic.
What we have seen, this is not my thinking, is observation by the guys doing the research in the background, that wherever there is a gravitational field, mainly, you see this color blue. Means your system, that's why I asked you if the inner tube is the same color. It means half of your tube is behaving as gravitational, half as what do you call it, magnetical, and your center tube, if it's that blue, it becomes that kind of color. It's purplish blue. It's not a blue, it's purplish blue. And when you put your outer ring and then your inner ring, two inner ring, the two inner ring become purplish blue and the two outer ring stay black. And the inner ring, gravitational ring of outer ring, goes purple blue as well. This is something which it was shown to me yesterday, and it shows itself every time you do a heating with gas. When you create nano layers with gas, this is what they observe: purple ring inside, black outside, but the gravitational ring inside the bigger ring is purplish blue color, this color as well. So what we see is gravitational fields. It shows the system creating partial gravitational, partially magnetical field. It's very interesting when you see it. I'll get the pictures to show you. Thank you very much.
I also have it on a plate here.
We don't know. No, it seems to be very efficient. Pardon, can you repeat? Hello? Can you take it up? You have no voice. You have to change your voice.
Okay.
Yeah?
I also have it on a bit of copper plate. It's half blue and half nano-coated. And on this side, there's even some copper that stayed.
Isn't that from chlor as well, Mr. Keshe?
Pardon?
Isn't that from chlor as well?
Yeah, if it's chlor as well. But that can be from chlor. Yeah, we see that one from chlor. Or dried too fast as well.
Okay.
Okay. I'll try to get you this gravitational ring. You see this beautiful, what they observed. Because there is no caustic there. It's the way it's is nano-coated with methane gas. Anybody else? So we should see quite a few systems next week. People who can tell us what's happening.
Looks like we also have Glenn here with video.
Sorry, I have nothing to show you. I just want to ask whether it's okay to use like 3 volts and maybe 1 amp or 1.5 amps.
You get a faster production and goes black, I think.
Okay, and how much will I go?
Three volts, 1.5 goes black usually.
Okay, 3 volts and half amp. Yes.
No,
okay.
No, with the GANs, the electric current, 3 volts. Do you use 3 volts? Is your GANs blackish color?
No, I'm asking whether I could go even more. How much can I go?
No, you can't go too high.
Okay, so
1 volt, 1 amp is a good one.
3 volts and 1 amp.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Keshe.
Don't go high, because when you go, it's totally different thing. Let me explain to you. I've done this before. Can we go on the board? I was just talking about this, I think this afternoon, is when you make, I've been told to use my pen. when you make your GAN systems, you put a nano coated copper and you put a zinc plate. This, remember, as you did, is your nano coating, or I do it black, which you like it more. When you put your water in the salt water, if you use a, what most of you are doing is you're connecting these two together, and then you collect. I was discussing this with Armin today, I think, just this after this lunchtime. You collect what we call CO2 at the bottom. What you collect is gases of CO2 at the bottom. When they do the test, they see different gases of zinc oxides too. What it means, here you produce a mixture of the two. To get a consistent CO2 production, this is wrong. And a lot of you do it. To produce a consistent, complete maximum CO2, you need to add a load here. I was just explaining lunchtime. You need to put here something like LED light, something like a fan from a cooling system of a computer. It might not run, the light might not come on, or it might be on for a few hours and then it disappears. But it controls the current flow at the CO2 level. When you have a high current across, you are creating gases of zinc, because now you create a current somewhere around 0.5 amp and something like 1 volt. So partially you're creating zinc oxide gas, partially creating CO2. If the environment in this area allows the production of the gravitational magnetic field of CO2. And then when the scientists do a test on this residual, they tell you, don't see zinc oxide. And by tell them, okay, you see a chemical zinc oxide, you're looking for matter. This is what we were discussing lunchtime. You're looking for a matter state. In plasma technology, you're looking for effect, which means you ask them to do a Raman spectroscopy. Then you see the behavior of superconductors. So you got to realize what you're doing and what current flow you're releasing in the system. If you create the right gap, the right distance between the two plates, and you leave your two plates outside, you still will collect CO2 without any zinc in it. You have seen, you can pick up a bottle of water and take it upstairs as Alex does. He goes to his neighbor's house with a bottle of water, he still produces CO2 in the bottle upstairs, on a different floor around the house, where there is no zinc. Because the environment in the house and in the building, because of the amount of CO2 he is producing in the environment, is come part of the balance. Everything in the house is nano-sized. Everything is nano-coated. So wherever he goes in the house, he can produce CO2. So he doesn't need zinc. Don't forget, this is what it is. If you have a plate inside and the current is something in that region, the way you produce copper oxide as a nanogans, because you have the plate, you're producing zinc oxide in a gaseous state. And then because our technology has a plant, there are two ways that they can actually measure what is in the material is by firing it. They fire at a high temperature, and what they will see is carbon. If you go with Raman spectroscopy, you will see behavior of CO2 plus another 13, most probably superconductors materials, which on the list of the system, most of the European system in Raman spectroscopy, infrared spectroscopy, will say some of these materials which are shown in here are exotic materials, and some we hope in the future mankind can produce them because they don't even exist. But your material shows superconductivity behavior of these materials if they existed. And then if you use copper oxide and a copper to produce copper oxide CO2, a nano-coated copper, you will see behavior of 22 different superconductors. So, first of all, understand you have to use a resistive material to create a constant balance. That's why every time we gave our material to be tested and we told them what to expect in our spectroscopy, they see the behavior of CO2, because I use zinc, I use nano-coated copper, but if you see in all the pictures, there is always a resistor, a light, a motor, small cooling fan system of a, what do you call it, computer. It doesn't run, but in the background, the energy balance stays the same. And if you don't do what I see a lot of you do, just get the two wires and they connect it, you have high current. If you have a salt or your salinity is different, it leads to creation of oxidization. And one of the things you know this is happening is that you very quickly lose all your nanomaterial and your copper, because it works both ways. The current now, it flows, don't forget, plasmatic condition, it flows both ways. As much as you produce in this, then you see sometime green material in your CO2 or your zinc material. Always use a load. You want to guarantee CO2 production, use a load on the top. This is very important, because if you don't do it, then you make assumption what you have, but you actually don't have. And this is one of the reasons that in the new system, we for the CO2 box, which is designed, hopefully if we manufacture it, you have a possibility to put your plates outside the water, outside the box. You don't put your plates inside the box. So what you get is totally plasmatic what is inside. There is no possibility of zinc inside it. But as you've seen, if you create the right environment in the house, most probably you do. What is interesting, those who are using these systems quite a long time now, 2, 3 months, 4 or 5 months, they tell you they don't even need to connect their system when they go into the cars. Once the system comes to the car, the steel cars produces the efficiency you're expecting. You nanocoat, you energize through interaction of the fields, not chemical interaction or current flow interaction. These are little things that a lot of you who are coming into nanotechnology this way have to observe.
Mr. Keshe?
Yeah.
Your mic's dropping a little bit more. Can you move it away from the tie again, please?
Is it better now? Hello?
I think so.
Okay. I could hear it click-clicking, but I didn't know what it was. So these are little techniques you have to start observing. Otherwise, you find different effects, different properties, and especially a lot of you which or who submit these technologies to your governments, to your institutes to be tested, they come back and tell you, we've seen only nickel or whatever. You have to explain to them what it is, the reason it is, and you have to produce it the right way or explain to them to do it the right way. I used to produce a composite of caustic. Then if you learn how to create composite caustics, then the ball game is totally different. When we submitted the three samples to the Belgium Nuclear Center for testing, I gave them composite caustic, which I think about the liter of each we gave them the first time, and they wanted to know if it was something random I could create, or can I repeat it? They came back and said, can we have some more of? So I created the same thing again for them for 1 liter or 2 liter more. Because then I found out they burned the material and they found things that they could not imagine could be there. When I gave the composite caustic, I gave to them, one is the composition of the blood of human in a caustic. One is the composition of the solar system, and one is the composite of the caustic of the universe. You've got a long way to go to learn this. And they wanted to see if I can repeat it. And it took me 2-3 days producing 3-4 more liters, and they were given. I can show you the documents from the SDK where they requested for this. So you have nowadays, you only get one thing, and you have an NaOH or potassium or whatever you use. But there are hundreds of different ways of composite caustics to be developed. You can do it. And it's each one has the, what does a caustic means? Caustic means having the ability to create nanostructure. The human body, our blood, is one of the most active caustics ever existed. Its job is to create nanomaterial. If you look, when you look even at the lymph, one brings, if you call this the blood, the emotion, and call this lymph, one brings a nanomaterial. And the other one brings the emotion of it, which is how it's going to behave, and this gives you the current. Human body is one of the most active caustics we can have. It's extremely active. It produces nanomaterial first immediately to the energy that it leads to creation of the GANs in the presence of lymph. Immediately nanosizes it. It's so powerful. So just don't look, you can produce. The cosmos caustic is very, very soft. It's extremely soft. Earth, or what you call the solar system, is slightly different. More. But for human body to be able to produce very rapid nanostructure that it changes to a GANs to become a cell of your body, it has to be extremely active. You put NaOH in a bottle and you wait one day to nanosize. You have to see millions and millions of cells are created immediately. Caustic energy at the plasma condition creates with a lymph a given current, you got your GANs. Look what you do. You gave it a current, you gave it the right voltage, see what happens. You produce the GANs there from the material. You can see how powerful this thing is. you got to learn, if you want to produce the cell of any part of the human being in a rapid state, what we were discussing yesterday, you have to learn the caustic of the blood. It's one of the most amazing. It tastes like your blood. It has a specific structure which stays energy transmitter than actual matter transmitter. You feel it. When you carry the caustic of blood of a human, you feel the energy. It's when I carry the caustic of blood, when you carry it, you feel the energy because it's part of you. You feel it. It's like carrying, when you have a Tabasco on your tongue, that's how you and your body feels like. It's not burning, it's but the energy transfer is huge. You got to learn these things, it takes time. So understand, caustic is not just one thing you do. You got to understand the composition, what it brings. What means to be able to create nanomaterial and automatically what your lymph and your blood does, you have to look at it this way. The energy comes, nanosizes in the presence of the blood, change to GANs, in the presence of the current, becomes a cell. It's extremely, extremely efficient. Every point, if you say 0.05 amp, here we say 0.5 amp. If you go to 0.5 amp, you go to 0.5000000001, it's for one cell. And then you do this, blah, 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 to another cell. And between the thousands of divisions. It's so effective. The lymph brings the cancer state of it. The blood caustic creates the nanostructure of it that the current dictates what is going to manifest itself. To understand the human caustic, human blood caustic, you need to understand the totality structure of a human psychological, emotional, because even emotion has a certain strength in the caustic of blood. That's why you have emotion in the blood. You have to understand it and create it. One day, I'll teach you. When a man finds peace, I show you how to make it, because anywhere in the universe, when you land, then you can create a perfect man. You don't need to, what they call it, cloning. Cloning is a wrong way. You can do replication of man through his emotion, which is his RNA, through the caustic of his blood. Remember, you carry oxygen, energy in your blood. What does it mean? Disinfecting. Most of the production of the heat in the sodium. See, I prefer to use OH is the oxygen. When the nitrogen in the balance in the plasma turns to find its position in respect to change in hydrogen and the oxygen, huge amount of energy is released. You have to understand the operation of the plasma in the blood. Is not chemical interaction. You have carbon, you have oxygen, you have hydrogen, and you have nitrogen. In the plasma, when you look at the plasma condition of the amino acid, you have three base and one top. 16, 12, 14, and one the hydrogen. So what the plasma tries to do, it chases to find balance, and then in the up position, it releases its energy. If you find the hydrogen moves its position where the 14 comes here, the 16 is closer to the hydrogen, and 12 in this position, you find a different behavior from amino acids. Depends. You don't look, if you're looking at this to be in one plane. This is not in one plane. Oxygen, what do you call it? I can take it off. You have carbon and you have nitrogen. If I can get it, it doesn't want to work it. And then you see your hydrogen here. You look, it's not on one plane. We draw it this way for you to see. If this is the oxygen and this is the nitrogen, what happened when hydrogen is still the same? Position of carbon doesn't change, but nitrogen come in a strength higher than this. It's totally different behavior. You got to look at the amino acid as a plasmatic interaction. And then you understand how sometimes and why hydrogen behaves as a disinfector in the blood circulation. Because it allows a very rapid change of energy. What does disinfecting mean? It's take energy from what is not needed. And the hydrogen is there to accommodate it through carbon. When you look at the plasma technology in a human body, not as a chemical or atomic structure, then it's a totally different way of working. This is how it works. It doesn't work the way we see carbon there, a chain reaction, this is the muscle and this is the fiber. It has never worked. It's a gaseous state, the operation of the human body has to be considered in the gas level. That's why we have different, and each one of us, our blood is different and it behaves different. Because as a gans, they position themselves in a different way. You could have this position and your brother could be like this, but the same material. You see, it's slightly different. Or your mother could have this. Now, it's totally different composition. And then, when you have such a different composition, the whole structure of your cells in your body is different. That's why you cannot give, what do you call it, organs to each other. That's why we have different texture of a skin. There is a bracket, for example, that this can be within energy level of a plasma. And this one somewhere here. But nowhere these can be in exact position even in respect to the hydrogen. This is why our blood, our skin, our tissues are different. Because the gravitational magnetic field of the plasma are totally different for each one. The human body is not a chemistry lab, it's a plasma lab, it's a gas state. And every position releases a certain current, certain voltage, demands that, and that in turn decides even about your emotion. Because when I have to put too much to oxygen, which is so high, I have less to give for the backup for something else. Emotionally, I feel different. This is why we have certain people, we say such and such a race, they are usually happy people. What does that happiness mean? What does it entail? It means there is a position where less energy is used. When there is less energy used, you are more relaxed, you become happier. So it means the gap between different levels of the plasma of the amino acid are very close. It's not huge. This huge gap comes usually from huge consumption of meat. Because everything is more energized, the gaps are bigger. So the jumps are bigger. And then when the jumps are bigger, you have to use more energy to cover. Triggering aggression, because you all want to absorb. So to absorb, you need higher plasma covers, which is the meat for transfer. So you understand the total structure of the human body in a plasma condition. And this is how it works. It's not, there is so many limbs here, dot here, and something works as chemical reaction. It's plasmatic. Any other question? Are you sure? Let me see if I have battery. I'm not flashing. Is it better now? Yes. Father? It's clear. Who?
From France. Yeah, nice to meet you, Mr. Keshe, and thank you very much for everything that you did for us. It's amazing. I was going to ask you, what about the pulse square wave to create the GANs?
Pardon?
The pulse square wave, like for hydrogen, when you create hydrogen with the two plates, you use a pulse square wave. Only costs €2 from China with the volume. 12 volt, 24 volt, 36 volt, go down to 3 volt.
I don't understand. Explain.
What this. I think what
you know, you've got a sine wave and you've got a square wave.
Yes. Yeah, you do a square. Yes.
So would it be better to use that than doing to this normal oscillation?
I don't know.
Ah. Well, I was trying to do a coil, like you say, for my fire. I did nanocode that.
What is that?
Was to create my hot water from my fireplace.
You're nano coating the pipe.
Yeah. My work one day, who knows?
And does it work better?
I just put it in, nano coat it first of all. So with 10 minutes, I've got hot water already.
Interesting.
It's copper, is it? Copper pipe?
It is copper, yeah.
And it's steel underneath?
It's stainless steel.
Yes.
So it doesn't get the current through.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah, in Europe they use what is known as double layering pipes in the stainless steel. And he's using wood, I presume, yes?
Or coal? Yes, of course, yeah.
Wood. What happened in the pipes when you use wood, you get the, what do you call it, soot or dust of the thing. They use these double layers to create a constant temperature, and then you don't get so much reduced. That's why they use a stainless steel, but he's putting a nano coating pipe on it. I can see the smoke of the wood in the background.
It's finished this morning. It's pretty hot now.
In a way, Mr. Keshe, would it not be, since I mean, in science they consider fire as a plasma, would it not be a plasma inside of a nano-coated coil here, essentially what's going on with the power unit? In fact, it's a dynamic plasma. It's moving through it with a velocity and so on, and with a, you know, a lot of turbulence and energy.
It works different. Then it's the temperature dependent.
How does temperature enter into the equation with all of this. We haven't really discussed other than when things get too hot, then the circuit breaker will go off.
The temperature is a kind of active magnetic gravitational field, which in action creates the same gap as we look, as we call it, gravitational magnetic positioning, but in reference to the strength of the gravitational magnetic field of the Earth. That's what we call temperature, or we raise temperature. If you work in a Gans state, the Earth gravitational magnetic field doesn't count at all. That's why in the Gans materials you feel cool temperature. Temperature is part of the structure of the environment, gravitational magnetic field interaction. And when you have a lot of it, it creates a distance in respect to the totality of the environment, not in respect to the gas. I'm going to take you back to the screen and explain. Thank you very much for showing it to us.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
What happened is that okay, what happened in plasmatic condition in a gaseous state, molecules or a molecule, or atomic structure molecules of the gas find gravitational magnetic field in respect to each other in this way. But when you bring the what you call gravitational magnetic field of the environment, then it's this way. But in fact, the material has not made any move. It's exactly in the same position as the gas, but position of the matter slightly moves in respect to its environment, but as the gas stays the same. Because this is the red line is the energy which the environment, the what we call inertia, the inertia of the material adds to the plasmatic. This is what I was explaining in a plasma field strength last week in the teachings. On Earth, you have gravitational magnetic field of the planet as is created in its center. Then you have gravitational field, magnetic field of a matter state, which is the inertia, which is again is gravitational magnetic field of the matter state strength, where the gravity is of the interaction of the fields in the center. In a plasma, we have the same condition. In a plasma, you have gravitational and you have the magnetical. And what happens? Somewhere here, the fields interact. Here, for example, let's give an example. The mass of carbon in matter state, we say is 12. Or you want to count it as that. Or go at carbon 6. And the actual gravitational magnetic field of carbon in a plasma state is something like 10. Because two of it is the inertia effect of the plasmas interacting in between. They are not from the central line. When you calculate the mass of a carbon, you go 12. When I calculate the plasmatic mass of carbon, I go for 10. Because I consider 20%, 30% due not from the center, but from interaction of gravitational magnetic field inside the system. With the copper, that's how we reach the carbon to be created in the CO2 box. Copper, you say 59. To me, is about 54, even as low as 52, maybe 50. Because when you have so many electrons and you have so many plasmas, the interaction creates a traffic jam that more fields interact. So there's higher possibility of creation of a matter state strength. So it's a composite of gravitational magnetic field from the center plus the interaction of the fields in the plasma. We explained this in the teaching of last week. And then when you work at this level, you find very quickly all your works is correct. You immediately come to, because now you understand you have to open the plasma. If you go in high levels into plutonium and those kind of thing, it changes quite drastically. In hydrogen, it's about 50%. You take hydrogen as one, in plasmatic mass is half. Because it's very open, fields interact very quickly with each other. So half of it is always the mass of the interaction. It's not coming from the center. When we speak about the mass, is what is coming from the interaction of gravitational pull against the magnetical. Here, if you look at it, for example, for carbon, if I go very big, if we say this is for copper, if there was no reaction the way you do, because you count the inertia and the gravitational magnetic field, you say, okay, it's 59. But the reality is there is a lot of interactions between the gravitational magnetic fields. There are a lot of matter state, what you call God particles, is created in the plasma of the copper. So when I calculate the plasmatic mass of the same element, I go the red one minus the blue. So if you understand the total structure, this is not two-dimensional. It's so many, for example, of these spikes continuously happening is about 20%, roughly 15-20%. This was 59 minus 10% is 0.6, let's say 15% is 10. I take copper around 49. That's minus 10. So you see, it's a big difference when it comes to talking about plasmatic mass or what's called atomic mass. Because in atomic mass, you consider the inertia of the total physical interaction of the field. Then you find out my calculation is much closer, and that's why we could calculate the distance between the copper nano-coated gravitational field and the zinc gives something around 6, which is a carb, what we're looking for. I pull in the neutrons. I work on the plasma mass of the neutron, the rest falls in, and it becomes part of the structure of the CO2. And then it interacts with the oxygen. Plasma technology is totally different than atomic or nuclear or present solid state mass. If you want to transfer energy through a plasma, is instantaneous. If you put, what we say, square waves or whatever waves through matter state of the copper, then you have interactions, you have losses, you have time there. But if you work with the plasma, you work through the field of the plasma. And it's instantaneous. That's why it's superconductor. It's dried on the winds you don't head on. If you want to understand the difference between the superconductor condition and a normal condition, it's very simple. You get on the aircraft, you come from Canada to, let's say, Italy. If you have a wind tail, you arrive an hour early. It's the same distance because there is this resistance. Nothing has changed. The same people, the same craft, the same thing. You ride on the winds of the magnetic field, on the magnetic field flow lines. You get that ride with no resistance. In matter, you get the resistance. And getting that resistance means you have more rubbish in the middle, you have to deal with. Because at the end of it, this thing still goes around different matter state field strength to come out. You have to start understanding the deeper understanding of the plasma, not just because you think is the way it works. Square waves, sound waves. We looked at the square waves for a specific condition. We're looking at the square waves to make a perfect square waves for medical applications. In medical application system, especially the Russian system, we are looking at real condition where with this you don't have, you have different drops and highs. With a square wave, we look for certainty at that point. Certainty at that point. That's where it's going to be, and that's what the drop is going to be. It's hit and go. Here is a lot of hits. There is a lot of uncertainty. Would a square wave give us what we need? In plasma rapid change, we are looking for a square change. You want to go to a very high rapid speed of transfer of the plasma, you go switch on, you're there at that level. You don't build into it. If you want to build into it, yes, but in plasma, your main target is stepping. This is how cells are produced in human body. The nerve does not release, it just releases one sequence, one square wave, one shot. And then at that shot is for cell of the nail at that point. I think the plasma physicists will have a wonderful time now that they can understand the totality. And then when you go in the further steps into the soul of the plasma, the operational emotion of the plasma, then the game changes totally. Because the same way as you have what you call the matter state and the emotional state and the soul, in a matter state of physicality of the man, you have the same with the plasma. We explain this in the teaching.
So, Mr. Keshe?
Yeah.
Does that mean that using a square like that, a square wave like that, at different intervals could also create the matter state of that plasma?
Quite possible. This is how you have to control your emotion when you're creating the condition of the plasma release. When you are, as we are teaching you in regular teachings, when you hold your hand and you release the emotion at certain strength, you keep it as that. This is the GAMS, or you call it the emotional length GAMS. It's you who decide, I leave a package in one go. As long as you try to concentrate to get to the plasma to be manifest itself or to be there, you're in problem. The concentration creation of the plasma has to be in one shock, one square wave. You release it, and in that interaction it comes. Those who sit and say, try to concentrate to create plasma, they haven't found the secret yet. It has to be intention, emotion, and the release in one go to be captured. And then you find out it's just shooting a bullet. you drop, for example, a drop of nitrogen, liquid nitrogen, and it solidifies at a given point when it hits. That's what you're looking for. But those who sit and watch and try to create, plasmas by field and thinking, it means they have a long way to go yet. They have not understood the process. Because you decide that's going to be the plasma, and then when the plasma is created, itself decides what I give and what I take from the environment. And the give and take is not very different. I'm prepared to be at this maximum taking, and I want to be at this maximum giving, that I can guarantee the supply, the existence. When you start working the way we're doing in the regular teachings during the week, in the plasma world, you look for instantaneous one shot. This is what is done. The lymph is there, the blood continuously passes a point forever, 24 hours a day. The lymph is there 24 hours a day. It's the rapid delivery of a nerve at that point, the information, the energy, which leads to creation of the cell, because it came for that in that point. Is, if you want to explain it, is a spot laser welding. Nerve is the laser beam. It hits. One quick, done the job. If you look in a lot of, I'm sure I have a lot of hope for the fat boy. Now they're going into the plasma condition supply. If they understand how they can feed the plasma, they just don't connect it and wait for it. They find out everything grows together. It'll be difficult, not so easy. But if they realize they can keep a connection between the stacker unit and the fat boy, and with the intention decide the energy goes to this, or the energy goes to number 3 or 4, because now they have the plasma system, they don't need to look for a physical interaction. Now they brought a supply next door. These power units will change a lot of things if you learn to detach from physicality of the connection, but look for magnetic field interaction connection, and understand that you, as the structure, has your capability and your parallel system, can affect it. Something you haven't realized, a lot of you. Those who make their own system, they will report to us fantastic things. And the rest of it is impossible. How come he can do it? How come he can get his system flying, but we can't? I bought the system from the Keshe Foundation and it doesn't work the way he does. Yes, do you know why? Have you realized the guy, when he took a unit and when he made the twist, because he's doing it with his own hand, he has left part of his soul, part of his fingerprint on it. He has the connection. How are you going to find the frequency of the guy in north of Italy, which is making the system and you're hoping to fly? You'll find people who, while they are making these systems, are not carried away. When they were praying, hoping that the system they make will bring peace to home, it bring peace to their soul, that they don't have to worry when the next electricity bill has to be paid, because there's no more electricity bill. They already established the selling quid. They already tanked, they put the energy, the emotion into the system, so it works. You have to understand this, otherwise you are back into the matter state and wasting your time. Shut it down and go home. You got to be aware at all time what you're interacting with, why you're interacting, what's the reason you interact, And then if you understand that, it brings to condition of your soul. How your soul does, what is the soul interaction? Why do you create a condition with the soul? These all counts, it's not anymore materialistic. If you are still happy with running a car with 30% fuel loss, that's your job. But those who come to the Space Institute to become the passenger of the space have to understand the totality of the ethos of the space. Your emotion, your soul, your physicality counts. It's very much what I said yesterday. How many of you kiss your partner good night when they're asleep, or tell them I love you when they're asleep, or your children? Pardon? When is the last time you kiss your wife in sleep? Tell her I love you. When you know she's asleep. 2 years ago. He's been here, poor chap, 2 years. And the last time he was there, he had to wake up and jump. It's Mr. Keshe again. Understand something very simple. Your soul is the connection in the life of physicality in a different dimension, but is of the same strength. A human being in a human structure has capability of all. You have a soul, that's the Simon Templar, I call it. You have the emotion, and then somewhere down the line, we make you green because you're Martian, you have physicality. You can take by the right conduct to receive, to attain a higher level, or add to the strength of, if we call comparison to position, to your soul. This is the state of the mind. If you're not happy with the soul because the behavior of the physicality and the emotion is not right, you can ask to receive, to elevate, and by elevation, receive a new emotion, which with it, the same physicality will behave different. You see, there's a switch. Every man has the capability, and every man has the capability to keep part of his soul in that direction. When you pray for your parents when they're dead, or when you say thank to somebody, or when you give part of what we call praying your soul to somebody, you elevate their position. But then they have to decide if they want that elevation or not, because they know they've done something wrong here that should stay there, because the soul cannot be fooled. This is a state of mind. When it comes to the state of prophet of God and the messengers of God, they have the same physicality, but slightly different. They carry something here, parallel to the physicality. But when you accept status of prophet or messengers of God, you have the two running parallel together. Where this has to be accepted by the soul, and the soul has to be accepted by the emotion that creates a new conduct for the physicality. And the two have nothing to do with each other, but they coexist next to each other. That's why you see the man as a prophet, as a physical life, he still eats, hunts, or whatever, and then you see the message which comes to elevate the person. A lot of prophets of the past, they have made this mistake when they interact their souls as their messengers, because it's literally, if you look at it, is of the highest order. Take this one and you work on the power level, it's somewhere, let's say, at this level, much higher than the standard of the physicality. So they have enlightened their emotion, and their physicality does not change. But the behavior, because this is what I said, in the gaseous state, in the plasmatic state, you're not looking for physical indication, you look for the effects, and you see the change. Then, in most of the cases, prophets of the higher order always have their partners. they come the same to balance. And they usually can bring with them that state of the punch. Then you offer the soul to a body. If the body accepts both by emotion and physicality, then the soul finds its position as long as the prophet stays. Because when the prophet was, the connection was because of it, it does not, the link is cut. And this is why, in most of the time, you see that with Mary and Christ. We see that with, in one position, with the first wife of Muhammad as his name and Khadija. With the rest, we don't see. So, then you see the elevation of the soul brings elevation of thought, and then they can change their physicality. As I said, learning about the plasma is not just an energy box. You have to understand the ethos and the working of the plasma. You have to understand how it comes that everything interacts in a direction and in totality. You have to accept, especially this system works worse, and it's been seen, works worse when the messenger is a woman. You don't want to know. Yes, hit your head. Because they work through a different operation. A man messengers usually work on the individuality base. But you have to understand, female prophets look at the totality. And then they set different standards for social structure. When we come, tangible life is a gift for us to see our partner in soul. And when it's not accepted physically, it does not take place, the knowledge given, accepted by the soul, is rejected. And you see the knowledge disappears very rapidly. We've seen that in the recent past. So, it's not the physicality, it's the level of the strength. If the standard, the prophet of life, the normal man, let's say is 10 to the power of 10, the soul of the prophets is something like 10 to the power of 1,000 plus. And universal messengers are totally different condition because they understand the totality, they are not conditioned to one planet, one nation, or one area. The universal passengers are equal to the prophet of the God, are themselves as part of the Creator. So you have to understand, when we say we are Messiah, it means we are aware of the totality. But in soul, we give equal to everyone, that we all improve and all become Messiahs, which means we are prepared to change the course of the totality of the soul of one planet. Messengers, they come on, if you go by human race, every few hundred or a thousand years. Messengers, universal messengers, when the time of change is so drastic, appear every billion years, even further. Very rare, and it's happened now, and it's part of the course of humanity. You have to understand what is delivered. You do not look at the man, you look at the information and the knowledge which is brought to bring man into the universal community. So you have to have knowledge of the universe in totality, not washing your hand or praying so many times as do the messengers of the earth. One of the things you will understand, when you carry the totality, you interact with everything, without them knowing or not knowing. When you are the emotion part of the brain, you deal with the totality of the physicality because you interact with all of it. It's not one point with one point, one piece with one piece. Stronger covers bigger area. And if you understand this, then it's you who decides what to give, the way to give, and how much to give, to what to be manifested at one point. They all are made from you because it's your emotion given to it, to your nail, to your toe, to your heart, but at the same time, they're independently operating at their own emotion. This is very important. When you understand this, then when you make the space reactors, you behave the same way. You gave to the reactor number 4 at a given rate in a certain corner of it to create a motion in a given direction, because now you control it. In a coming time, when you change pilots in the spaceships, you understand how you do it, you hand over. It's very much like a shift job. Then is the energy of the emotion which takes over according to the totality, not a key that you're going to write. Don't forget, he's not a driver. He thinks, puts his emotion, it's the direction when the flight takes over, the speed it goes. If you look at the structure of the space program, when you had the reactors, when you added different layers of GANs, you saw the difference, how it was. Now, if you understand this, and this was your top reactor, now, if you control, if you understand, you decide that the emotion, because you control it, the plasma will change at instant spot in this direction. As we said, if this is your craft, this is the direction which you change. You don't go and change a valve or change the wings or have a flap or whatever. It's the intention in where you deliver a strike. Exactly how in your brain you produce a nail of the toe this morning, and you come back in 3 weeks' time, you create the next cell next to the other side of the toe. In case if anything goes wrong, the other cell can support it. Now, you have to learn control of the plasma through emotion, and then you understand how, if you look at it, we work as prophet of God. This is the simplicity of the structure. And if you understand this, you understand the structure of the physicality and the messengers, you, in time, when you go to space, you become part of the same structure, because you come to the communities, environments, which are in knowledge, strength, understanding of the creation, not at the point you are. Let's say there are the man 1,000 years ago on this planet. Is for you to educate. That's what I said to Caroline years ago. She said, why are we here? Why man into earth? I said, the job of the man, the one who elevates, they become the messengers in the space. Then you have to learn correctness from the beginning. For those who come into a space, they live in the same instance. You're all looking for a free power. We are teaching you to join the universal community. And those who take the step, they will see the pleasures of the beauty of creating. This is just the carrot. Any questions? Ah, my microphone is so much adjusted. This is not from me. A little bit higher. Is my nose okay as usual? I'll buy myself a nose ring next time. Then is my mustache rubbing against it?
Mr. Keshe, before Rick, before you go on with your questions, could you elaborate? You mentioned Mitraism, Mitra. What kind of social structures were there? I mean, was it like a perfect social structure to meet under Mitra, Mr. Keshe?
Mitra was one of the very first female prophets, and she brought justice. And the whole of the structure of even today's society in the East and the West is based on Mitraism. She was just, she was correct, she was balanced. She understood the effect of emotion as a woman in what can do and what cannot be done. Mitra appeared in what we call Central Asia, East Asia, West, what we call it, West, what we call now Middle East, in the West, not East Asia, in Middle East, in east of Iran, in that area, and the Christianity of today is part of it, Islam is part of it, Judaism is part of it, Hinduism is part of it. All the religions we have now, the essence came from Mitra. In one way or another, it's been changed in name or behavior. Yes. Mitra is a woman. Yeah, you changed it. Yes, because Mitra is Mitraism is Mitra originally is a woman. It's the creator he gave life to. A lot of things have changed to fit. It is, you have to understand a lot of literature, especially in the East, in the, what do you call it, in the West, especially in the Catholic countries, have changed to fit into what the popes wanted to have. If I always said, it's just not the way they, when the Romans, if you look, I was talking this about my son yesterday, we're coming back from Bari. You know, what is this? If I can find the colors. I'll put them a different way next to each other, or if I create a right gap. Don't forget, here's a white square. If I put this in this way, or whatever way you want to position it, change of position. Do you know what is this? It's the flag of Iran and the flag of Italy. We go that way, you go that way. Because Iran and Italy used to be more or less one nation. The Romans and the Persians lived and ate and grew together. A lot of food you have and we have is the same. And in that process of interaction, before Christianity, most of the Italian rulers were Mitraism supporters. And it was prophet, it was a religion of elite in Roman time, in Roman Empire. And then when the common people accepted the Christianity and the power were losing, their position, they brought a lot of Mitraism that translates into Christianity, what you have as Catholicism. All look at all the structure of Mitraism, look at the festivities of part of Japan, Iran, the Central Middle East, is Christianity. They just changed name to keep to power, but they just kept the same temples, they moved it one thing to another. We have temples of fire, the lights on the Christmas tree. Well, we have candles on our tables. We have the 12 days of New Year in Iran. You have the 12 days of Christmas. Mitra had 12 disciples, in reality. They say, I have established the start of the Mitraism with creating the core team with 12 members. But that, I've explained, is totally nothing to do with it. So, you see, a lot has changed to keep into power. Chameleon changing color. But then everything else which could be different has changed. But if you look, all the religions now, they have the same base. Because if you look in the Mitraism, which became Zoroastrian, it says, talk good, do good, think good. And that's the three principles. Because then the foundation is a human or creator on the top, which creates the second, what you call mystical heart. In essence, all the beliefs is in two, one unity. But now we see the division in the path of belief to the same thing, which is the creator. But that's why the Keshe Foundation, we say one nation, one planet, one race. Then we don't have these divisions, because when you go to Mars, when you go to in space, nobody asks you, are you Christian, Muslim, or Jew? Are you from blah, 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 I'm from Earth. And we are all from Earth. We come from one planet, we are one nation, and we are one race, because that all they want to know, we are a human race. And to be a human race, it means the unity in everything. There are no borders, not in the universe, not on this planet. Any other question?
Yes, please.
Is that Shandor?
Yes, I tried to ask a question about to clarify how to properly connect the wires. We are twisting them in anti-clockwise direction, but which one to which one? So shall we twist the exit over the entry of the next coil, or just in the opposite way?
Entry, exit to entry.
So exit to be rolled over the entry?
Yes, is in series.
Yes, I was not sure about which wire to spin on.
Your magnetical of the first coil gets connected to gravitational of the middle coil. The magnetical of the middle coil gets connected to the gravitational of the top coil. And then you have the magnetical of the top coil in one end hanging, and you have the gravitational of the bottom coil hanging. And this you put in series in a live line.
Yes, so I'm trying to show...
Release the map, release a blueprint tomorrow. Then you can follow it very easily.
Yes, how about the twisting? Twisting in this style would be okay?
Pardon?
I'm trying to show my camera.
Yeah, we're trying to expand you. We see your beautiful face, but it's so tiny, we have to guess where the line is. Wait.
Okay.
Okay.
I put it over the front.
Yeah. Show me. Yes, we can see you.
Yes, so... Hello. Wire is rather thick, and even after softening it by heating up to red temperature...
What are you trying to make? The capacitor?
That would be the next question. So I'm saying about twisting in this way.
Yeah.
Not so easy, because it's a very tough wire.
So you should have bought a soft wire.
I noticed.
I don't know. You haven't bought a copper wire. Yours is a composite.
Yeah.
Like your brass. Yeah.
This is we can get as electric wires.
Yeah.
Probably it has more phosphor in it. It's quite hard to twist it. So probably it will be needed to repair the nano coating once they are all set up together.
Wait. You got to explain. There it comes. Armin is taking his jacket off. It means he's very serious. He's coming for a battle. He's walking in, the jacket, that's your microphone there. Unless you want to speak to my chest, you can speak to his. Okay, go. You want this? Wait. I'll give you a new page. No, oh yeah, that was a good one. Go.
When you have
when you have your coil already winded up, this ends, just you can, you know, with the torch, you can heat it up. Only the ends.
Yeah.
Then you don't deform the whole structure. When you nanocoat afterward, you know, it's very easy to twist. So you're not going to have a problem.
I know. Let me explain. This, actually, he's a master in his job. He tries so many different things. Excuse me. This is your problem, not mine. What Armin is explaining, let me find a piece of iron. Yeah, okay. When you make a nano an encasting, when you want to nano coat, you have a hard wire. Before you nano coat, he says just heat up the piece you want to twist to each other, and then nano coat. When it comes to twisting, it's not hard; it's a soft twist. It's an easy way to do it. I've got to tell this to the manufacturers. It saves a lot of time. I've seen the. This is a very nice tip. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Also,
per twist.
Yeah, this
you
is.
You make more than a foundation. Yeah.
May Pardon? I show my screen again?
Pardon?
May I show my video again? It's under here.
Go ahead.
So this is what I am using.
Just the tip. Don't go to the coil, just the tip.
Yeah.
That's it.
It's taking a bit of time until heating up to red hot. So it softens it to some degree.
You see, still, it can hold. Okay, not, thank you, Sandor.
Okay, still, it's not very easy to twist it. It will need some skill.
I've never seen a copper so hard as yours. It's, I think you bought a brass or what do you call it? Temper or heat treated copper. Somehow it's very tough. I see yesterday when you were showing it.
Yes.
Even the long wires that you cut for nano coating, extra wires, you just, you know, do the fire, heat him up, and it's very easy to turn.
A lot of people don't understand the difference. The difference between nano coating with caustic and nano coating with heat is this, because we have it here, you see. When you nano coat with caustic, you see it's very rigid. When in nanocoat with heat, you see it's very soft, you can manipulate it. It's a different process. It's the same batch. We did this with nanocaustic, what do you call it, with caustic, stays rigid, so handling is different. Where when you do heat with a gas, it just very, very soft, you can manipulate it. Yes, sir. And then you put in the casting. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Sorry, it's Chandra again. When I purchased the wire, the only grade which was available in the shop, but I was in several places, it has a code which starts with letter H, and H means hard.
Yeah. So you should have put S, which is means soft.
Something like that.
Something like that.
Yeah. Next question would be, this is a repeated question. In the morning, we had many times put this question, and in the afternoon, it came back into question and answers. So many people would like a second explanation about how to make and how to connect the capacitors, because they didn't got well the information.
First time was free. Second time, we charge.
No.
How to make the capacitors? This is the way I make. This is the way I've made capacitors for some time. You take your wire, you take a piece of tissue paper, or well, not tissue, what do you call it? Fireproof cooking?
Baking paper.
Pardon?
Baking paper.
Baking paper. And then you just put your GANs on it. What you do, you put your nano-coated wire and you turn it on its own, very, very tight. It has to be extremely tight. And then what are you going to get? You get a lollipop. That's your lollipop. Here we go up. And then what you do, you get a wire, a coil, which you just stick the nano-coated copper in it. This is your negative, is incoming, this is your positive. Don't forget, all these lines have to be turned in. When you do it, it's like rolling a cigarette. You push it hard, anti-clockwise. Next question.
Just before I forget.
Yes, yes.
I just wanted to make sure that we announced that the new blueprint sharing site.
Pardon?
The new blueprint sharing site?
Yes. Do you want to explain it? You're a webmaster. Before I get it wrong and then you tell me I've done it wrong.
Well, if you go to blueprint.keshefoundation.org, we're going to have a place where people can put up what they have built and pictures and video of what they're building right now. So if you go there, there's instructions on what you can do to provide that to us.
That is blueprint.keshefoundation.org. Foundation.org. And remember, this is different from Magrav. Which is which one? Keshe Foundation?
It's not live yet, but it's keshefoundation.org/magravs.
This is for when you get your units, you go on Keshe Foundation, /magrav.org. This is how you find a manual, how to connect, what you have to do, what you don't do with your power units. What we said to you a couple of months ago, that we open the blue bank for the technology for the factories that they can come and use. Now we made it public. You go to the blueprint, keshefoundation.org. Thank you very much. I was waiting for Carlos to come and announce it. Now you've done it. It's already running. I looked at it this afternoon. It's nice. It's got pictures. I think it starts with the pictures from Richard. But it's done the way he's doing his systems. And every pictures will be added into different people you can add to, and you can comment, advise. So it becomes a chat room for the people who are developing or producing. And if you see tips, we put it into the keshe.magrav.org for the people who are using the system. Thank you very much. As you see, the number of .org's Keshe Foundation agents or distributors and the rest is just adding up. And we need more and more people to look after these sites, these links, that they can respond to and it can be live. Next question.
People that have been waiting sort of patiently here, and
one of them has been me. I haven't asked my question yet. Okay.
You haven't asked your question. Michael wanted to show some of his spring or reactor combinations. Michael, are you able to share there?
Yes, I'm fine. Yeah, when you're ready.
Okay, let me cancel the video and you should be able to go ahead there.
ready. Okay. Yep. I just want to show you. Can you see my devices?
Yes. Is there three of them? We can only see two there.
Let me get it right.
If you can hold the camera steady, then we can get a better picture.
Let me hold it up.
Okay. And just tilt down a bit. There we go. All right, so you can see that you have three coils built there, and I'm presuming they're the double coils, each right. One. Okay.
I'm going to show you. I've got some work going on in the caustic here. I've got the next set. Sorry. Can you see?
Yes, you can see them down there.
I've got an X-ray inside here. That this is my caustic gem.
Okay.
So that's how far I've got so far. I'm concentrating and I'm connecting them together.
Are you going to coat those with GANs?
Oh, yes, these ones are coated. I dip them. I've got some GANs. Made out of diamond and titanium.
Okay.
Yeah, and I dip them in it, so they are drying at this moment.
Rick.
Yes.
Are these single coil or are they embedded coils?
Single rod.
Oh, okay.
I think the wire around the edge is a twisted one. You've done other work with the twisted wire, haven't you? Michael.
Yes. Is your coil twisted wires or a single wire?
Yes, single wire.
Single wire, okay. Yeah. No problem. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Keshe. Thanks for your knowledge. Yeah.
Thank you indeed.
Thank you, bye.
What's the next one?
Okay, we've got Denise wanted to ask a question.
Can you ask, what's the question?
Hello, can you hear me? Hi. Hello, can you hear me now?
Hello,
Mr. Keshe. I appreciate the work that you're doing and what you're bringing to the world.
Thank you very much.
I have a twofold question. One, first, I'm delighted that you're bringing this information to the surface. I personally have been visited by Mitra, and have been quite significantly directed by the energies that she brings. One of the things that I've become very in tune with is what we call or are known as the indigo children. And I've noticed in studying these behaviors that they display, is there imbalance with the current plasmatic display of Earth? In other words, we're not into.
Before you go, Frederick, can you explain to us who are ignorant to this, what is the indigo children, please?
The indigo children are the children, the children who are coming with a high vibration. Many years ago, it was explained that these children already have a higher aura, a deep purple aura. And so they're coming with different vibrations into this three-dimensional space. They're bringing forth a higher level of photon expression. So they're being seen with more purple aura, so some more third eye expression. At any rate, I've been studying them, and myself included, took on a test and discovered that we have higher levels of copper, and we're what's described as undermethylators. So I'm kind of proposing or questioning whether these children, because of higher levels of copper, are already in tune with the plasma of a higher order of photon being expressed here on Terra.
I don't know.
In other words, they're already coming prepared to manipulate the forces of the technology that you are putting on the table.
I don't know. I haven't seen one, so I cannot tell you.
One of the things that I've discovered in being an undermethylator and going more to a vegetarian diet, you explained a little while ago that the being on a meat-driven diet, you know, creates a more dissonance type attitude. But one of the things that I've experienced is my vibration is definitely increasing, and I'm becoming even more psychic than I was before. So I'm kind of questioning myself whether, you know, these are the transitions that are, you know, gradually being expressed.
There is a question I explain in some of the teachings in a very soft way, and that is, when we go to space and we find a balanced energy, how is going to be our behavior?
Mm-hmm.
How are we going to behave? Are we going to behave as the vegetarian, or are we going to behave like animal behavior for the meat eaters? Or does our behavior comes from our intentions, that we demand higher energy to be able to do what we want to do? We don't necessarily need to be vegetarian or meat eater. We have seen horrendous jobs from the vegetarian world leaders, as much as we've seen the daily meat eaters. Is the intention what we directed to? And what we find peace with? You'll find out people who go to space and work through the plasma technology, understanding the work of the plasma, they become very, very serene people, extremely serene, because they take what they want when they want, and we start creating a new breed of human race, content, very placid, and people who nothing matters, because they know they can have whatever they want when they want. Somebody's doing a woodwork on a plate somewhere. It's the intention which you release dictates. We have warriors in vegetarian eaters, we have as much warriors as we have meat eaters. The surface energy which changes the intention, but intention, it changes the physicality which touches the intention at higher strength. Any other question? My God, what is the request? Let's first listen to the request. We can always say no. I will say next question.
Yeah, sorry, my microphone wasn't on the live stream. Yeah, it's Tio. Are you able to speak there? Let's.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, it's not a very special request. I just wanted to ask.
Wait a minute. Let's get you on the video there so we can see you. Okay, go ahead now. Thanks.
Thank you. I just wanted to ask if I can work in Italy with the production of the.
Pardon? Can you repeat?
Yes. Can I work for foundation? Can I join the foundation? Can I work?
What are your talents of better than us? Because we have no
special talents. I'm just a simple electrician.
Oh, that doesn't count.
You were talking about working in the factory, weren't you? And you wanted to work in. Yeah, he's talking about working in the Italian factory.
Italian factory, I have no say in running of it. That's how we made the short from the beginning of it.
Could he apply like as a worker there?
I'm meeting with the management next week in Rome. It's been structured in a way that I have no say. I will never have a say.
Okay.
I see.
Running our employment. We don't release the whole structure in due course. It'll be done. But we will employ a large number. We estimate we should employ up to about 3,000 people in coming weeks.
Oh.
Because we see the change. But we have a premises in north of Italy and our agreement is that in the coming months we'll move to not very far from Bari. There's a location which will create a few hundred jobs, not far from the center. But it'll be done through, what do you call it? I have no say. I've deliberately made sure of that. That people don't come to the foundation that it guarantees jobs or positions. But if we find people of special talents, as part of the manufacturing, will move here on the fifth floor after Christmas. We place them inside the factory.
When you said special talents, sorry, do you mean energies?
Anything. In Italy, let's put it this way. In Italy, I have, what do you call it? We employ 99% Italian workforce. The 1% most probably comes around the Keshe Foundation headquarters because we come from an international background.
As a matter of fact, sorry, I'm not Italian. I'm Romanian.
Where are you? Are you in Italy?
I live in London and I'm Romanian.
Ah, so you got to wait till we open the Keshe Foundation manufacturing. If you want to work in the factory or with the production side, there is a plan. We'll disclose it about the Keshe Foundation. It'll go on the Keshe Foundation UK.org. It'll come up soon. Okay. And the factory will go that way. The base will be most probably around London.
I see.
Just the things to be done, but that is totally, again, we are a major shareholder and the foundation keeps out of the day-to-day operation of the factory. This is how we work and we will operate.
Okay.
But if you have a talent, if you're looking for a job in a way of what we are short of in the background, speak to the webmaster. It depends. We need a lot of, you might have a talent, we need more than anything else, but I'm not in that position. We need a lot of support in the technical background of the running and everyday administration. And here in Italy, we're trying to recruit majority Italian workers on the premises and with the same in UK and the rest.
I see.
Well, I tell you, you could have used this very person here in the last couple of months to run a cable from upstairs to downstairs. It would have solved all of your internet problems.
We had the Italians, that's what they did.
Well, that's the problem. And here's a man that could have done it, perhaps, you know.
Let's put it this way. We all have talents. We all have capabilities. We all can help and serve.
I lost my camera. Can you still hear me? Sorry.
Yes, we still see you.
Okay. Thank you.
It depends what you can do or what foundation has there. We were discussing this with Vince this morning, this week with a couple of other people. We are short of at least 10-15 manpower in the administration side, which we got to fulfill. But then all the sides by people like Sandor, Ella, by Vince and Rick, who know exactly where the gaps are and Stanley and people who stand in the background, they know what is needed, where is it. I'm away from decision making from this, and these people run the foundation, they know.
I see. Thank you very much. appreciate.
I can tell you. Speak to Vince and Rick in the background. They know if there is something.
I understand.
Thank you very much. I keep away from these things totally, because then that's why they're there. They run the foundation in the background. They are the principals. You speak to Armin or Marco, and you know, the assessment comes and how it's going to be.
And also, I suppose people, as the Keshe foundations in various countries get set up, they can contact their local Keshe foundation to talk about getting employed and that kind of thing.
There is a huge opportunities in the employment around Keshe foundations around the world. We support some, the others, they can support themselves. But at the moment, Carlos is setting up all the Keshe foundations worldwide. In the coming maybe 3-4 weeks, all the foundations around the world will look exactly the same. Doesn't matter where you go from the page point of view. They'll only be different languages and what they are doing to set up the servers, that it all goes through one server. Depends what your talents are or people who want to join us. I think we should sometime in the coming days or months put an employment list that what we are looking for different people, even from Keshe Foundation Manufacturing.
Okay.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Keep in touch with Rick and Vince, the decision makers, and that side if you need.
I will.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I'm wondering if we have time for Kel L here. What do you think? Should we wrap things up, or how much longer do you want to go here?
What's the time? 5 o'clock. No problem.
We have a couple of other participants as well.
Kel's been waiting from the morning, so let's see if we can get to him.
Pardon?
Vince says that he's been waiting. Kel L's been waiting since the morning, so perhaps we can
see what he has to say.
Go ahead. Also known as Phoenician.
Hey, actually, it's the second camera that you guys have to pull out of the viewer, and I believe it's Bay, Krishna Bay. That's the name it's under.
Pardon?
I got it.
What is it?
It's just, we got two cameras, Mr. Keshe. That's all.
Can you open it?
How's it going? Can you hear us?
How you doing, Mr. Keshe? My name is.
Like to produce the alum that actually has a charge, and then we use that to create a battery. We use different type of metals. This is tungsten carbide with the nano coated wire, which we got GaNs from as well. This is a different kind of GaNs we got from the same metals I just described. You can see it. We got the original CUO. You can see all the GaNs that we got here. We just got different ones. We also got the composite GaNs, all the GaNs that we put up.
It's fantastic to see you like this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's absolutely a pleasure to see you.
Thank you. It's a pleasure as well.
If you are. Are you going to develop the power units? Oh, they have everything there.
Yeah, we've been using different metals from CNC cutting tools.
Right.
And they are composed of tungsten and carbide. So these metals have very high melting points. So we've been creating some very dynamic gases. Okay.
So explosion this without the running water, and this these are the coils for the reactor.
Yes, sir.
How come they're red?
We are still working on finishing the nano coating. We've been up all night coiling them.
It causes a lot of problems for a lot of wives and girlfriends.
Yes, sir.
I hope you opened a monocoat Bob Marley over there.
Yes, sir. And we've been saving.
What's the orange you're doing on the top of your box?
I'm creating the GANs of the orange.
And we're creating a caustic solution made from the wood, because wood has a very powerful gravitational fields on it. We have different kind of woods. This right here is the red oak, and you have right here water oak. It's very potent. Like, even when you use it for cooking, people, you can still smell the smell on you if you was to leave and go somewhere else. Yeah. What we're going to do is make a caustic solution from the ash.
And we have also been testing rainwater with our GANs reactors, and we've been getting some good results with that as well.
Wow. What kind of results do you get from rainwater?
We get a very fast GANs production.
Yeah, and it has a little bit more power to it as well than using, because we actually originally started off using just a regular battery when we first started off, and we realized that, you know, that was making a weaker GANs. So we began using batteries that we actually created using composite GANs with the alum that we added.
How many of you are there in that group?
It's four of us right now.
It's the same right here.
We've been up all night, Mr. Keshe. We've been up all night. And KL has been doing a wonderful job teaching us in America about the new plasma technology. So I want to thank him, and I want to thank you also, Mr. Keshe.
Right. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to see you and to have you with us.
Yes, sir.
But please keep in touch and show us when you made your reactors or your power units.
Yes, sir.
And we can support you in any shape or form. Keep in touch with Armin. He is my God.
We got the Alex. And, as you can see,
I'd appreciate it if you guys go on to the blueprint.keshefoundation.org and send some of your photos to the address there.
That'd absolutely be gorgeous.
Yes, sir. Okay. Will do.
Peace.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. I did want to say one other thing. We had started a process by which we were taking a copper coating off of the pennies. We were putting the GANs reactors on the outside on the decks, so that we're pulling the CO2 right out of the cars as they're driving off the highways. So I've basically been starting from just teaching.
What is the zinc pennies? Is it
that they're zinc? They're 97% zinc after 1982.
Right.
They just have a copper coating on them.
And it has copper zinc pennies.
And another thing that we were going into was changing the different composites for the caustics. And on that reactor right there, we're actually using a different kind of bead set in order to use it as a load for the CO2 GANs that they.
Which state are you in?
Mr. Keshe, this is just the first group, and they are in Louisiana and Houston, but there are mothers and children that are nano coating all over the country. It's a group that's all over, man. That's right, baby. That's right.
This is absolutely fantastic. Maybe, as I said, if you can make the power units, it's done in the kitchens, it's done in the living rooms, it's done in the only place they don't do it is in university laboratories. But people like you will change the course.
Yes, sir.
Because you are in the grassroots of the science, in the grassroots of the plasma technology. And it's fantastic to see you.
Yes, sir.
This is the highlight of the today, maybe this week.
That's what I'm talking about, Keshe.
Thank you.
If it's about 500 of you and the mothers and children are doing it, and you can teach them to make the coils,
I understand the situation in the US quite well in so many ways, not very well. You can bring energy into your country in a very, very effective way. And through it, maybe we find new dimension in peace there.
Yes, sir.
One of the beautiful things I've seen is the way, the simplicity you have done this. The way you collect. I've never seen such a vast connection of ganses or materials which can give you energy. If you mix them in a very correct way, you can have literally whatever you want. What to do? Write a list of the things you have in your ganses and add them in drops. Literally add them as drops, drop of each in a container. And like the orange and everything else, and then use the water of it, water right. of the gamma, there you do, and add it to your coils before you wind them up as an energy power unit. And then in the future, I'll tell you what you will get from it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for everything, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you.
Please keep in touch. We'll come back to you.
Peace and love to you all. Peace and love.
Thank you very much indeed. It's a pleasure to see you.
Peace.
It's fantastic. Thank you. That was fantastic.
Mr. Keshe.
Yes.
This is Kal-El again. I did want to say that that was just one group. We have set up something that's all over the country, probably in every state. There's at least somebody they're doing it in different stages. I really have been focusing on producing as many kinds of different ganses as possible. So that's where I've been talking about a lot. But yeah, this is what we're doing.
I think if you created such a grassroots to start teaching people to start making the what we call the coils, and to use these ganses in changing the course of humanity in the United States.
Yes, sir. That's what I'm trying to do.
It's the roots. It's deep. When I see people like you, it makes all the hard work worthwhile. I know it's not easy, but when you lot get in concentrate on one thing, you change the course. And a lot of people like you are the people who change it. You'll tip it over because you make it, and I know how it'll go. Everybody will do it because they see the change and the time for a change.
Well, thank
you very much for coming on.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
You managed to wake them up. This morning you couldn't wake them up.
Yeah, they fell asleep because they were really prepared. We were really talking about, you know, preparing for it. And it's been about 3 months I've been teaching, and just we've really been going hard at it. So, you know, I just wanted to make sure that we had something good for you, Keshe. That's all.
Try to keep in touch with Keshe Foundation US, and I'm sure there is a lot you can do for the Keshe Foundation USA. Armin is with it, and there's a lot can be done because it's going back to the state this week to set up the manufacturing side of the Keshe Foundation USA, and I'm sure there's a lot of opportunities for a lot of people the way we see it in the United States.
I did want to say one other thing to you, and that is I would really love the opportunity to go over every single one of these countries and do the same exact thing that I've done already.
What do you mean?
Set up a Keshe Foundation and teach the basics and move on to the next, and find people like Alex, because I think the best plasma physicists are going to be guys that are mechanics that just taught themselves how to fix things. And yeah, I think that they will provide great minds.
If you want, I explained to you, he has more or less set fire to the whole of Nigeria as he's traveling. They call him the Mr. Priest. He's spending day and night in Nigeria teaching about development of the GANs and the beads and showing people how they create small energies in the villages. And as I said, he's what I call the flag bearer of peace, and he's a gold. And if we can find like you lot and him, hundreds of you will change in no time.
I believe so, sir.
We need teachers. If you want, we need huge number of teachers in Africa. Huge numbers.
Tell him to get in contact with
them. As much as you have in the state, we need in every direction. Speak to go back into the Keshe Foundation US, make contact with Armin. I'm sure Armin can use you a lot of ways in teaching.
I hear Brett has some advice in the background too.
Brett?
Can't hear you, Brett. It's very low.
You're awake?
I'm always awake.
Can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
Barely.
We can hear you faintly.
I said have him get in contact with me or Armin and we'll arrange.
Can you talk a bit louder? You're not coming. We just hear whispers.
I think you need to get closer to your mic, Brett, instead of being out on your porch.
Pardon?
No, I just said have him get in contact with me or Armin.
Okay. Brett says to get in contact with him or Armin.
Use the Keshe Foundation USA. Add a point of reference and contact them. Go through, I think it's the webmaster. A webmaster is there. The email. Armin will tell you.
Actually, email Carlos already corrected because I was receiving emails, but I couldn't send emails. Whoever is sending emails to me. So it's corrected, so I can answer it right away.
Try what the way you're doing it, if we can support you, if you want us to teach or special sessions to the people you are teaching, we are here to serve, no problem. I know there's a time difference. If you are teaching so many people how to make guns and now you can take them to make the coins, and you want us to make presentations of the teachings directly from here, we have no problem for that.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you, indeed. Thanks for your time. It was a pleasure to hear you.
Hopefully next
week we see you with your coin running.
Where are you located at?
Oh, actually, I'm in Amsterdam now. I've been traveling. I travel a lot all over the world, and I wanted to go by and see Rich before I took off and left here. So I just wanted to check out his hookup. But I've been speaking with Rich behind the scenes. And also Rick and Vince also.
Thank you very much. When we see things like your cases, it works worthwhile all the works we've done. Because I understand it's not easy, but once it starts going and people can see it, you have to change them back into understanding what benefits it can bring to them.
Well, we're ready for manufacturing, Mr. Keshe. We've got a lot of ideas and a lot of creators.
Speak to Armin, or if you want to manufacture, get in touch with us here. We bring you here to after Christmas. You can bring groups, come and go on a regular basis.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
And then we support you in every way. As far as I understand from Armin, we have a very strong manufacturing point in US. Which he should announce in the next couple of weeks when he comes back in the state what it is. You got to remember that we will support in all the designs. What it means, not only the blueprint of the circuit you have, we deliver the blueprint of all the castings and everything to the manufacturing side, because it's no good for ordinary people. But to make these castings and everything else we can support, there's a discussion even with Armin we had with another side that these casts can be manufactured cheaper, like in Tehran, and distributed from Iran across the world in a very fast way. Because the Armenian Keshe Foundation group, they want to do it in Tehran, they find it. So if we do such a thing, Tehran becomes the casting point worldwide that we can support it. We'll see speak to Armin, he's in the state next week.
Mr. Keshe,
through the Keshe Foundation, and then see how we can collaborate in manufacturing across the US. You need at least a couple of thousand manufacturers in the United States to meet the demand. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. We really need it. Thank you.
Thank you.
You want to get the email out?
Who's the last one?
Do you want to get the email out, Vince?
Hello?
The email to which, Brett?
Production, manufacturing, and
it goes email to the Keshe Foundation. What's your email, Armin? Is, I think, webmaster@keshefoundation.usa. Yeah, it's webmasters@keshefoundation.usa. Send your email only. Do not communicate if you want to work with the foundation outside the framework of the foundation. You'll find a lot of people will come to you, they want to do it. It's your prerogative to do what you like. But if you want to work with the foundation, keep within the structure of the keshefoundation.com.orgs around the world, but they go through the same structure. Any other questions? Shall we call it a day?
I think we should probably wrap it up here. Because there's other questions we could go on all night. So
thank you very much indeed.
People can come in the morning. You're going to be here for tomorrow.
Tomorrow, right? You'll be there tomorrow, right, Mr. Gus?
Pardon?
I said you'll be there tomorrow, right? You'll be here. You'll be teaching tomorrow.
The teaching today is still on the blueprint tomorrow because we're going to release the key tomorrow.
Okay.
And tomorrow afternoon, I think if I'm correct, sometime in the afternoon, because nobody here can tell me, we're going live on satellite. Am I correct? Yes? You don't think so? Ah, okay. Pardon? You don't have the answers. Okay, then that's what we've been told. If that's the case, we'll have a couple of hour presentation from the camera crew, or they decide a different way. But more or less tomorrow, we go through the last phase. Any questions for Blueprint? And then we release the Blueprint in totality, the key of the Blueprint, and then it goes on a total run of see how we go to the next step for the miniature units, for the what they call cascading units and the rest. And on Monday, there is a possibility that we shut down because it's the 1st of November holidays on the Sunday. Some people would like to have a Monday off, or you can run it internationally and we be back here for the rest of the blueprint on Tuesday, Wednesday to see people what they made, what results they get, because the essence is not just making this unit, it's to show how it works, what are the parameters, how we can use it, and from now on, collectively, what we can gain as a plasma. Thank you very much for today.
I just have to mention that web address is not correct, apparently.
Which one?
The one about the webmaster at keshefoundation.usa.
He's checking it. You know, it's Armin. It's just waiting.
It's webmaster@keshefoundationusa.com.
Right. So I've got a little, on the live stream, people can see that. I've got a little thing in the corner where they can see the correct one. It's webmaster@keshefoundationusa.com.
Webmaster
at keshefoundationusa.com, not at
keshefoundationusa.com.
Right.
Yeah. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you for all your work. See you tomorrow morning.
Okay, great. Thanks, Mr. Keshe.
Thanks, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you indeed. Thank you for your time.
And thank you, Michael. Thanks to Cal L. Thanks to everybody who presented things today. That was a big boost. And to everyone who attended. Thank you all.
Hey Rick and Vince.
See you tomorrow.
Hey Rick and Vince.
Yes.
I wrote you guys a note when I first logged on, and I said that I would keep throwing stones at Keshe Foundation until you guys came to the window.
Yep, well, we're watching.
All right.
Okay, so let's end the live stream. The recordings, Rick, you just want to end. live stream and then the YouTube, I guess, and we'll.